So with your blood you bought our freedom. Can't explain your love. You are ruler.
Ruler of everything.
Yeah. Worthy of all that we could bring. Yeah.
You are great Jehovah.
All power. Put your hands again. Hey. Without performance. Without performance.
Come on, if you believe it, lift your hands and declare it. Our defender, you are the most high king.
Thank you. over your spouse, over your loved ones, over your parents, over your siblings. Just begin to pray in the name of Jesus.
Thank you.
close your eyes all over this place. Ain't nothing gonna jump on you. Don't worry about it. Except the Holy Spirit. Just close your eyes. Extend your hands before the Father today. Come on, without anyone looking around, just extend your hands. Close your eyes. Extend your hands. And just begin to speak the name Jesus. Come on, because he knows what you have need of. Your Father knows what you need of before you even ask. So just begin to speak his name. Say, Jesus. Jesus, I acknowledge your presence is here. I acknowledge your presence that's here. Whatever it is that you have for me today, God, I make space, I make room for what you have for me. Because I know that you are here right now. I know that your presence is here right now. I know that you are here. We love to row. Come on down. Come on, 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 come on. And when you come down, go ahead and do what he told you to do. If he told you to come down here and get on your face, then come on down here and get on your face, get on your knees. Don't worry, somebody will help you back up. Partial obedience is still disobedience. You did it halfway. That's not what he said.
For chains to be broken, for minds to be regulated. Now you can sit there if you want to, but sometimes you have to move while the water is being troubled. And if you're in this house right now and you sense that there is something that is holding you down, holding you back, it could be pain, it could be frustration, it could be depression. On the count of three, I need for you to step out from where you are and start moving. Because while you start moving, chains are going to be broken. There you go, right there. In the name of Jesus, we declare that your power and your might and your glory and your strength, while you're moving, chains are being broken. Spirit that's trying to hold you back, we command in the name of Jesus, loose and let her go. Get your hand off of their families. Get your hand. I need somebody praying right now. Get your hand off of their finances. It's not too late for you to move, but while you're moving, you know, the woman that had the issue of blood was determined not to let anyone, not to let anything. That while she was moving, something started breaking. Sometimes you gotta push stuff out of the way, pushing back the darkness. I dare you in the name of Jesus to push back the darkness. Come on, sing it now. Awesome move that we have experienced thus far in this service. We thank you for the sign, you said, signs and wonders in the earth, and testaments and testimony of your power and your glory, for your glory. And we've decided to call on the name of the Lord, to lift bowed down heads, and in your presence, we recognize there's the fullness of joy. And at the right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. We thank you for the saints and those that don't know you that will, after the preaching and teaching of the word of God, will come to know you as their personal Lord and Savior. But we wanted to stop and pause and pray and thank you for all that you have done for us, doing in us, and the best that is yet to come. Now, Lord, we pray for this service on today, that, Lord, all that we have need of, your hands will provide for us, because great is your faithfulness. We pray for that which someone has need of, that you will meet the needs according to your power and according to your strength. We pray, Lord, as well for our senior pastors, Drs. Marvin and Deborah Jackson. Thank you for their leadership. Thank you for their love. Thank you for their compassion. Thank you for their word. Thank you for their vision. For without a vision, the people perish. We're here because someone stepped out on the promises of God and said yes to him. And so we honor you and we give you praise. And we thank you, Lord. As we move further into this service, we thank you for what is about to be revealed in this place. And we will have known that it was good for us to have been in the house of the Lord. Would you give God praise? Clap your hands as you go back to your seats. I will do, as you go back to your seats, I will do. I will do. Today and as he was asking how are things everything's all right. I said, Pastor, you know, one of the signs of a remarkable leader is not just how the church and how the ministry carries on in your presence, but how that ministry functions in your absence. Come on, give God praise for that. I said, because you have taught us very, very well. I said that we got it covered, Pastor, for you, but we honor them and we thank God for them and thank God for the word that Dr. Deborah delivered on last Thursday on the power of love. What's love got to do with it? Clap your hands. Come on, how can we live on God's level? How can we dare live on God's level without having the God kind of love? It's impossible to do that. But we praise God again for them and for the word that's been ministered into the house. And we are so glad, so excited for all of you that are first-time guests that are a part of the River Nation. Come on, give God praise for them. You're here. We love you. We praise God for you. Thank the Lord for you sharing. For those of you that are tuning in live stream as well, why don't you do us a favor? Why don't you put in the chat line and let us know where you're tuning in from? But we praise God that there is always a word here at the River of Life just in store for you. And we thank God again for you tuning in. To our first-time guests, would you do us a favor? Would you just slip your hand up so that we can see who you are? Keep your hand lifted up very, very high. Oh, come on. Thank God. Thank God for you. Well, our pastors send you their tremendous love and thank you. Out of the many churches that you could have stopped by and visited on today, you decided to come and be a part of this place that we call the River Nation. Here, one church in multiple locations here in Orlando, but also in Palm Bay as well. So we appreciate you and thank God for you. And we do have a special gift for you. If you'll do us a favor at the end of the service, if you'll stop by our information table, we'll make sure after service, again, if you stop by the information table, we'll make sure that we get into your hands the gift on behalf of this church. Saints of God, one more time, clap your hands for our guests being with us. All right. Well, you know, it is the month of September, and we do have some birthdays in this month, the month of September. All of the September birthday believers, saints, would you please do me a favor, stand to your feet. Look at this. Look at this. There is a special way that we honor, we celebrate you. Please remain standing. The way that we celebrate, honor you, we want to wish you the happiest of birthdays. And from the River of Life, we want to say to you, groups will have a table set up in the lobby area after church to provide information about our life groups and how you can get engaged, how you can get involved, how you can sign up. Life groups on finances, faith, and family, things that are designed to be able to strengthen you, allow you to be able to be all that God has charged you to be. We praise God that you will avail yourself to that information immediately following our service. Also, you do recognize the aesthetics of this building, this campus as well. We want to keep it that way. Certainly there are paid staff members that throughout the week, they take care of the sanctuary to make sure that it's right for you, but we have to do our part as well. And we do our part by not eating or drinking in the sanctuary or gum as well. We do have a cafe. There are areas for you to be able to enjoy yourself, but simply not in the sanctuary. We just honor the Lord and thank you for following that announcement accordingly. All right. Don't forget to join us at noonday for noonday prayer. That's Monday through Saturday. Men ought always to pray and not to faint. We understand that. And even now, so as we see the day of Christ approaching, we need to assemble ourselves together. So thank you very much for those of you that continually consistently participate in the prayer call as well. You are helping to make it happen. Give them a good God bless you. Thank you very much. All right. If you have completed, well, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, we are all members of the body of Christ, but we need all of the parts of the body to be functioning in their full capacity for us to be effective in all that we do. And if you are a volunteer and you've been taking a little time off, and we understand that, but it's time for us to get back in the game. It's time for us to return and serve. And we praise God for you. If you have completed the volunteer orientation meeting, we need to have your requested paperwork back within 2 weeks. We need to have that done because we just don't want to continue to have your information, you know, like some places they have folks' information that's forever and a day on the roll. We don't just want it on the roll. We want to roll it. We want to move it. We want to get you activated. We want to get you involved. We need your help. We need to give a reprieve and relief to some of the volunteers that are part of this house, this ministry that work time and time again. They would also love to be able to sit and to enjoy the service as well. And they won't be burdened if we all do our part. I know you can do that, and we praise God for you. Give God praise for that. Thank you. Thank you in advance to all of our volunteers. All right. Also, if you have received calls or text messages, we're asking that you do please listen, read those information. They are sent for our information, cancellation, confirmation, or registration. Texts are automated, so please do not reply to them. Before we turn our direction, attention to the monitors for the continuation of the announcements, I do want to say thank you to the love of my life who's here with us, standing and sharing together with us in ministry. My wife, Pastor Josette Cohen, for 33 years. I'm going to have her stand too. You are my lady. You're everything I need and more. Y'all watch out over there. We praise God for them, and we also thank God for Dr. Joanne Garland and my mother-in-law, and we appreciate you. We have a friend of the family whose wife just went on to be with the Lord. He came from Wisconsin. He's here today with us. We praise God for Assistant Pastor Charles Templin, who's here as well. And to all of the saints of God, we also praise God that our deacon has returned back to the house of the Lord, Deacon Carlisle. You know, with the set that he has on right now, he's got matching shoes down on. He got a boot and a matching shoe. We appreciate you. We love you. We thank God for you as well. And having said that, we'd like for you to turn your attention to the video monitors for the following announcements. Ready? Roll up.
Hi, I'm Salim Nuruddin. We welcome you to the River of Life Christian Center and Virtual Church. We are so excited you chose to worship with us today. These are your River of Life announcements for this week. Be sure to visit our website, ROLCC.TV/coronavirus, for the latest ministry updates on all activities and the current COVID-19 virus. There's power in agreement. You're invited to dial in every day at noon as we pray for our families and our nation. There are 4 convenient ways you can continue to support the ministry. Stop by our website, ROLCC.TV, click the Give tab, and scroll down to select one of the giving platforms or donate via our church app. We are here for you in a challenging time of crisis. Visit our member care page on our website for more information.
The River of Life will hold a baptism September 18th during our Sunday morning worship service at 10 a.m. If you would like to be baptized, please register at the information desk or on our website at ROLCC.TV/events. Registration deadline is Sunday, September 11th.
Hello, River of Life family. My name is Marlon Brown. And I am Shanae Brown, and we are your River of Life Life Group coordinators.
Did you know that joining a life group is life-changing? Why, you might ask? Because it allows individuals to come together to build, uplift, encourage, and empower one another based upon God's word.
We have several life groups available: family and marriage, faith and purpose, biblical financial literacy, and even for single mothers. We have something for everyone, and we would love for you to join us in our upcoming seasonal semester.
For more information or to sign up, go to our website at rolcc.tv and click the Connect tab.
We look forward to seeing you soon.
In observance of the Labor Day holiday, our church offices at both the Orlando and Palm Bay locations will be closed Monday, September 5th. We will reopen Tuesday, September 6th at 9 a.m. to serve you.
Remember to join us for our worship service next Sunday at 10 a.m. at one of our two locations, River Orlando or River Palm Bay, and our virtual worship service on Thursday at 7 p.m. In the event that you are unable to attend our Sunday service, please join us as we stream live on our website, Facebook, or ROLCC on YouTube.
Don't forget to pray for every member of the River of Life, lost souls, and especially those that are in your family. In the event that you have missed any portion of these announcements or have any questions, you can call the church office at 407-835-8833 or go by our website and view them in its entirety at rolcc.tv/events and click on View Announcements. I'm Salim Nuruddin, and remember, the Lord has a word just for you, and you can find it right here at the River of Life.
Thank you so much for those announcements. All right. Well, it's time for us to bring our tithes, our offerings, and our gifts of love to the Lord. Let me go back over here. Let me try this again. It's time for us to bring our tithes, our offerings, our gifts of love. See, God does not get excited over mad money. The Bible says that God loves a cheerful. And by the looks of some of y'all up in here, that God's been very good to you. Even in a famine, somebody's been eating some steak and some lobster. Even in the midst of famine, I know the gas prices are coming down, and we praise God for that. But you know what's a blessing? That even when the prices were going up, God was still sustaining us. Sometimes we have to praise God that we may not be where we want to be, but we're not where we used to be. And He will give seed to the sower and bread to the eater. When we do right by God, He'll always make sure that we have more than enough. That's what causes me to trust Him even the more. You know, there's a scripture that's found in Matthew's gospel. It's Matthew 6, 31 through 33, and in the Amplified Bible, look at this. It says, "Therefore, don't worry." If I were to borrow a page from the script of Lil Wayne, he'd say, "I ain't worried about nothing. Don't trip out. Don't be anxious. Don't be perplexed. Don't be uneasy. Don't become distracted." Talking about, hey, where are we going to eat? What are we going to put on? You know, how are we going to make it? God's already got that covered. Isn't that a blessing? Things that I may be distracted about, He's already taken care of. He got that. And He's got it because He doesn't want us to be filled with depression and discouragement and distraction so that we can focus our time and our attention on Him. Can you turn to the Exodus 32? What does it say? For the pagan, for the Gentiles, if I were to coin the term, I would say those that don't have a covenant. See, there's a difference between those that walk in the covenant of God and those that don't have the covenant of God. David understood that when he went out to fight against Goliath. He said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine? Uncircumcised has to do with doesn't have a covenant, doesn't know God the way that I know him. People that don't know God the way that you know him, they need to be worried about stuff. But people that know God like we know him, we don't have to be discouraged. We don't have to worry. We know what needs to be done, but we're not worried about it. I see it, but I ain't worried about it. Because he already knows the things that I have need of. But what am I going to do? And we're going to receive our gifts right now. But what are we going to do? But first, seek first, watch this, aim for, strive for his kingdom, his way of doing things. See, if you're not careful, trusting in the Lord and abiding by the things of God, you'll try to do things to make your way of increase. You'll spend every bit of $10 with the scratch me off. Been there. You'll spend every bit of the $20 with the 4594. Because we're trying to make our way. But he has already made the way for us. Seek first his way of doing things and being right. And all of these things will be provided for us. Father, we thank you for the opportunity that we have in this house to be able to sow and bring our gifts to you. It is a pleasure. It is an honor for us. This is an act of our worship. Bringing our gifts to you, that is not outside of the realm of worship. It is a part of our worship experience. And we thank you that you supply all of our need according to your riches and glory by Christ Jesus. And we give you praise, Lord, that as we continue to be faithful unto you and to trust you, Lord, you'll continue to do the things that are beyond our imagination. For eye hadn't seen and ear hadn't heard, and neither is entered into the hearts of the things that you have prepared for us. We trust you with all of our heart. We lean not unto our own understanding, but in all of our ways we acknowledge you. And a part of our acknowledging you is the confession of our faith, the confession of our mouth. And we understand that through our confession, it brings us into our possessions. So with our mouth, we begin to confess through the word of God, and we're saying it. I'm out of debt, my needs are met, and I have plenty more. Look over at somebody and declare this word to them. Tell them, you're out of debt, your needs are met, and you have corporately, as a family of God, let's say it together. Come on. We're out of debt, our needs are met. Come on, shout glory in the house of the Lord.
Thankful for the presence of the Lord. Amen. Anybody else grateful for God's presence today? Hallelujah. Come on, as you're putting that offering, that gift into the bucket today, after it's passed, so you can go ahead and stand to your feet and just continue to worship the Lord with us this morning. Amen.
October, we're going to go out. The rule in October of 2015, I was on my way home after having worked at the school. And I rolled the window down in my truck. This was in Wisconsin. And as I'm going down this intersection, I see this car coming down the side of the road. I said, this kid's about to hit me. The young man who had been drinking and using drugs, hit my car. My truck flipped one way, and I rolled out of the window the other way. Sitting on the curb there, at a point between death or life, I said to God, don't let me leave here like this. Because I know you're a holy God. And I know that the end of my life is not going to be out here on this corner. So I don't know about you. I'm not alone by myself. There's some survivors in this house that have been through something. You know them to be holy. I need you to declare, say,
oh,
participate. Services like these, you don't mess with God's glory. Anything that I would try to do that I prepared for beyond what he has done in this house would be me and not him. God, I'm not looking for a moment. If he gave me one, he'll give me another. I don't mess with God's glory or his presence. When I see God moving like he's moving in here, I just step out the way. Have your way, Lord. Because right now is the perfect time in this place to give you an opportunity that have never said yes to him to say yes right now. See, when the anointing like is flowing like this, it makes it very easy for you. See, we've already fought against satanic hindrances and obstacles that would prohibit you from getting up out of your seat, walking down to this altar, and saying, Lord, I'm tired of fighting. You're here in this house. Now, this is what I need you to do. If you're tired of fighting, I'm tired of struggling. Message that I had to deliver today was something has to change. You can't keep doing it.
That's what I'm talking about. Here and alone. Where are you? I'm coming after you. Where are you? Come on now. Start moving right now. Where you at? Where you at? Come on. Get up from where you are. That's right. Somebody start praying. Come on. Come on. Bring it up. Do it. Start coming right now. Get up from your seat. Wherever you are. Come out. Come out. Come out. Come out. Come out. Come out. Those of you that were in the service, you remember when the pastor spoke to my wife and I about the land that we've been dwelling in. We were dwelling in a place called comfort, called the Comfort Inn. Some of you say, you up in this house right here, you're dwelling in the Comfort Inn. I'm all right. No, you're not. You're just existing. But he's come to give you life. Life and life more abundantly. We come with a light to shine this light on those of you that have been living in a land of comfort, a land of ease, a land where I just want to do my own thing. But I tell you in the name of Jesus, every one of you dwelling in the land of comfort, to lift your hands, get out from the aisle where you are and say, I can't stay here anymore. I can't live in this land. Come out from where you are. Make your way down to this altar and say, I need more. I need, there you are. In the name of Jesus, tell them, excuse me. Let me out the road. Let me come on down. They're coming, they're coming. Praise God, they're coming. They're coming. They're coming, they're coming. Give God praise. That's it. That's it. That's it. You're not alone, sis. Come on, they're coming. Yep, that's what I'm talking about. Oh, Yahweh, pray. Come on. Clap your hands. That's it. They'll start coming. Oh, I've been living in a land of comfort zone and comfortability and comfortable with my job and comfortable with my home and comfortable with my faith. But God says, I got more than I'm about to do in your life. More than I'm about to bring you into. More than I'm about to what were imaginable. But God says, I'm going to do it by my strength and by my power. There they are. They're coming, they're coming. They're coming, they're coming.
go home, y'all. Come on.
Jireh, you are enough. And I will be content in every circumstance. You are enough.
Father, we thank you for your presence in this place. We thank you for the mighty move, the outstretch of your hand. For Lord, for you revealing yourself to us in this place, that all we have need, your hands have provided. Great is your faithfulness. Lord, you've shown us in the demonstration an outpour of your Spirit, that wherever the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. We sense the liberty and the power and the work of God here in this place. We sense chains having been broken and minds being regulated and hearts being fixed, and those not knowing you coming to know you, and those who are out of fellowship, falling out of fellowship with you, being restored back into divine grace. We just honor you and praise you that we are here in the place that's sensitive to the move of God. Thank you, Lord, for your people pressing their way out to the house here today. And thank you, Lord, for confirming your word. Even as we've been here today, we've known that it was good for us to have been here. Now, to those of you that are tuning in to this broadcast through live stream, you as well have an opportunity to say yes to the Lord. And if you have, and if you've made a declaration to honor the Lord with your heart, to let him, to invite him in, we want to know, we want to connect with you, simply to get some literature into your hands so that you can continue on in your faith journey with him. Would you please go to our website at ROLCC.TV. info@ROLCC.TV, and let us know that you've made this decision to follow the footsteps of the Lord, and we will be careful to get information into your hands so that you can continue on in your journey with him. And if you don't have a church home, we invite you to become part of the River of Life here in Orlando as well as in Palm Bay as well. It is good for us to connect ourselves with the living, with the active, with a house, a ministry where we can be fed and we can grow and we can be all that the Lord desires for us to be in the kingdom of God. And this is a place where we can fulfill the call of God that is upon our lives. And we praise God for him. We praise God for this place. For those of you, I know some of you that are in the house right now, I know what services are like these. Sometimes you just sit there and you're like, I just need a van. I just give me a minute. And we're going to give you a minute. If we could have the musicians just to stay for just a moment, we're going to dismiss you. But for those of you that just need your minute, sometimes we're in just such a quick hurry, just a rush to just move on to the next thing. We're going to dismiss you. But for those of you that desire to stay just for a moment for what we call the after glory, you're invited to be able to do that. But may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord make his face shine unto you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance unto you and show you his peace. God love you. God bless you. In his name, we praise God for you. Saints of God, just for a moment, the miracle in the house here.